Professor has just provided you with the information that the EBRD should have a president. To some degree, it has now even two. There's an outgoing one and an incoming one. On a slightly more serious note, I think it is indeed extremely important that there has been no situation and no time space of uncertainty. This must not happen in times like these, in which financial markets, as you all know, are extremely volatile, in which rating agencies look at international financial institutions in the way they do. So I think the stability and the robustness of the governance, which has been demonstrated by governors, is extremely important in terms of the efficiency and effectiveness of EBRD. I have, of course, already conveyed to Sir Suma my heartfelt congratulations. I really wish him well, personally, but also with regard to the future of the bank. It's no secret that because of the difficult times, also the EBRD will face very serious challenges, especially, of course, with regard to the fact that EBRD will now very soon enter into new territories and start to invest into the southern and eastern Mediterranean and to kind of translate and at the same time adapt the experience that we have drawn from our commitment to Central and Eastern Europe.
Now, President-elect Mirow and Chakrabarti, say a few words.
Thank you very much, John. Thank you, Thomas. I want to start by saying something about Thomas, actually. I think we've been very, very lucky in having Thomas Mirow as President of the last 4 years. He's an outstanding professional, firstly. What he has done here to deliver results in terms of the operational and financial efficiency, the AAA rating, the response to the financial crisis, and also the expansion now into the southern and eastern Mediterranean, shows great strategic vision as well as great professional integrity. And we were lucky to have him in these 4 years. The second thing I'd like to say about Thomas is about the man himself. He's an unassuming individual, Thomas. He wouldn't like me saying all of this, because one of the things about Thomas is he doesn't actually thrust himself forward in the way some people do. And that's the nicest thing about him, actually. He cares deeply about the institution, about his staff, and he wants them to take the credit. And of course, it is a team effort, but this team wouldn't have done so well without Thomas as its leader. And we are very, very lucky to have had him at the helm of this institute for the last 4 years. He is a great legacy for me and the team to take forward. We'll try and protect his legacy. It's really, really important, and we'll take it forward as well. The second thing is really about EBRD staff. I think this is an institution that I was involved in its creation, have been involved with over the years, with a short sabbatical, I suppose, for the last 4.5 years when I've been running the Ministry of Justice here. But I have enormous pride in this organisation, passion for its mission, for the staff, and the management here have done a cracking job over these 21 years. It's a bit of a model institution internationally, in my view. I'm pleased that the competition took place on fair and open terms. I think it reflects very well on the institution and on the shareholders. I think each of the candidates offered very different things and very great candidates, actually, great campaigns they ran too. And I'm glad the process was followed in the way it was. in the end, to have got very wide support from a wide range of shareholders within the European Union, both Eurozone and outside the Eurozone, and also across the rest of the world as well. I think that's a good thing for the bank to have competition, because some of these things is harmful. So I think this competition has been extremely useful, because the five candidates had very different experiences to bring to the bank and for the challenge ahead, and so the governors could choose on that basis. So I think it's a good and healthy thing for the bank. don't think it's about Franco-German culture or Anglo-Saxon culture or any other culture. Actually, I was rather interested in Le Monde piece today about Anglo-Saxon culture and so on. I mean, anyone looking at me, would they become Anglo-Saxon? Interesting idea. And if you look at my track record, you can see a very diverse top team. I mean, you know, when I run the international development department in the EBRD, who are my three deputies? A Pakistani, an Egyptian, and an Anglo-Saxon. Led by a Bengali Englishman. So I don't think he stacks up, actually. I think that each Wales president will bring some of their own experiences to how they run an organisation, how they want to do it. Thomas has done that before him, Jean Lemire did that, and Jacques Leroyer. Each brought something different. So some things will change, but I think you'll find a lot of continuity as well, because I'm very respectful of what Thomas has achieved. I don't think there's going to be some sudden changes. I was asked in the interviews, actually, what would you change in the first 100 days?